The right of the interpretation. Mine God, mine God, why hast thou forsaken me?
Right.
He let David understand the language before he spoke it.
That's right.
In the 22nd chapter of the book of Psalms, David already prophesied. It says, mine God,
right.
mine God,
right.
why hast thou forsaken me?
Right.
Here come God manifesting himself in the flesh, and here comes Jesus Christ crying out, Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani. David already talked about it. Mine God,
right.
mine God, why hast thou forsaken me? When did God forsake him? The spirit forsook or came out of that body so the body could die.
To
the spirit which is the Lord apostle on the earth, the preacher, the spirit that was in prison.
Right.
And the third day, the spirit got back in that body and resurrected and said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth.
That's right.
Amen. Are you listening?
But he that prophesied,
speaketh unto men. Speak unto men.
To edification.
So you can be edified.
And exhortation.
And exhortation.
And comfort.
And comfort.
He that speaketh in an unknown
tongue
edifieth himself.
See, if you speaking in an unknown tongue, if there's no interpreter, only you are edified because you're the only one who can comprehend what you're saying.
That's right. But he that prophesieth edify the church.
Because it comes in language so everybody can get it. Amen. All right?
Amen.
All right. We'll get one more.
All right.
All right.
This person asked, witnessing to Muslims. First, I praise God for Pastor Jennings' stand in Christ. The person says, Pastor, please explain how we in Christ as a brother who is strong in the Lord should witness to somebody who has knowledge of the Islamic faith.
Let's see who should witness.
Mm-hmm.
24th chapter, book of Luke.
On the book of Luke, amen.
You see, your idea of witnessing and God's idea of witnessing is two different things.
That's right, amen.
Folks running around trying to convert a bunch of people and not able to analyze or rightly divide the context of the book.
That's right,
amen.
See, when you talk to the Muslim brothers who have some knowledge of the scriptures, and many of them have sharp knowledge of the scriptures,
mm-hmm.
if you don't know what you're talking about, you're going to be up in a tree replacing a bird.
Amen.
You will make a nest your home.
That's right.
So, in fact, I advise you don't bother no religion until you first get holiness down pat.
Amen.
Learn God's way first, besides trying to bother other religions.
That's right.
See, first thing first, get God's way down pat.
Yeah.
And then strive to live by that.
Yeah.
It is written, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
That's it.
What you mean? The right way is concerning him.
That's right.
And then all things will be added those to you. And the mistake that many of you so-called, quote-unquote, Christians make, you go out there trying to convert everybody, and you ain't got it right yourself.
Right.
Do you understand?
That's right.
So my advice to you will be what Jesus said. Jesus said, learn of me.
Learn of me.
Before you try to convert, first learn.
That's it.
Learn first.
That's right.
So I wouldn't advise you to go out trying to tangle with Muslims or Hebrew Israelites or the Jews. No. Learn God's way first.
That's right.
And then work on self.
Mm-hmm.
And then once you work on self and you and God become one, when you master that, believe me, you do good.
Amen.
Witness to yourself.
That's right. That's right.
By going to the book of witness.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you're going out there arguing with folk and yet you can't, you may quote the right scripture, but then can't explain the scripture you quote.
Amen.
Then you're going to cause confusion.
That's right.
All right, you better give me the second chapter of the book of Acts of the Apostles. Let me close out on that. Everybody all right?
Amen.
My time is almost gone. All right, come on.
Acts chapter 2 and at verse 36. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly.
All right, viewers, I'm going out on this.
Therefore, let all the house of Israel know
assuredly. We're going home.
That's right.
Glory to God.
That's right.
Let all the house of Israel know assuredly.
That God hath made that same
that
Jesus.
That God hath made the same Jesus.
Whom ye have crucified.
Who is it?
Both Lord and Christ.
What is it?
Both Lord and Christ.
His Lord
and Christ.
And Christ. Meaning he was given authority to be over all.
That's right.
And he is the anointed one of God.
That's right.
That's what that is.
Amen.
And Lord and Christ.
And Christ.
God, it is written, God have highly exalted him.
That's right.
Huh?
That's
then
right.
he come along being the anointed one of God.
Amen.
One scripture says he's the Lord's Christ.
The Lord's Christ.
Huh?
That's
the
right.
The Lord's Christ. L-O-R-D apostrophe S.
That's it.
He's the Lord's Christ.
That's right.
The Lord's anointed.
Right.
That means the Lord owned him.
Mm-hmm.
That's why it said son of God.
Son
in
of
the
God.
English language, if you got of in front of something, you declare ownership.
That's right.
Of God. I mean, he belonged to God.
Amen.
That's what it means when it said Christ, God laid down his life.
His life.
God laid down his life. His,
that's right.
That don't mean God died.
No.
That scripture don't mean God died.
No.
Because God is a spirit.
Mm-hmm.
But when it said he laid down
his life,
what life? The life of that son was his.
That's right.
Because it was his son, his servant, his body, his flesh.
That's it.
That's why it says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
That's
God
right.
laid down his life. His life was his son.
That's right.
His life, his son. His son, life belonged to him.
That's right.
That's what that is.
Go ahead, man.
You preachers been saying for years that meant God died. No, it don't.
No,
God is the spirit. You can't kill him.
No way.
That don't mean God died.
No.
You better give me, listen. St. John 3:16, mm-hmm. Epistle of John 3:16.
Amen. St. John chapter 3 and at verse 16.
Listen!
St. John 3 and at verse 16.
All right.
For God so loved the world.
God so loved the world. God so loved the human family.
Mm-hmm.
That he
gave his only begotten son.
He gave his. Focus on the language of the book.
His.
He gave his. Mm-hmm. His. His. His only begotten son.
That whosoever believeth in him.
Whoever believe in him.
Should not perish.
Won't perish.
But have everlasting life.
But have everlasting life.
And in 1 John chapter 3 and at verse 16.
What is it?
Hereby perceive we the love of God.
Hereby understand we God love.
Because he.
Because who?
He.
He. He God is one.
That's right.
Because he.
Laid down his life for us.
Well, God's life is eternal. You can't lay down an eternal spirit.
No, you can't.
Because you can't kill a spirit.
That's right.
So God. Got a life and then took that life on.
That's right.
It is written, he took upon him the form of a servant. And the servant form that he took on, that was my Lord or the Messiah.
That's right.
He got in that form and worked in that form and then allowed that form life to be laid down.
That's right.
He offered it up once for all.
Once for all.
Through the eternal spirit.
That's right.
Just so Peter could come on the day of Pentecost and tell everybody to do what?
Then Peter said unto them, repent.
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 My God, I'm almost gone.
That's right.
That's what you got to do now.
Repent.
Not bow your head and raise your hand and accept Christ as your personal Savior.
Mm-hmm.
The scriptures did not say join the church.
No.
The scriptures did not say go to a Catholic church and go to an upright toilet and get water thrown on you.
That's right.
It didn't say that.
No, no.
He says what?
Then Peter said unto them, repent.
Do you get this?
Repent.
Get this. Why do God want you to repent? He wants you to be sorry about your wrong.
That's right.
When you're sorry about your wrong, then you start making effort for change.
Amen.
Repent.
And be baptized.
Be sprinkled.
Be baptized.
Water poured on you.
Baptized.
You got to be baptized how?
Every one of you.
Somebody say, well, I don't say that. Sprinkled or poured water poured on you. As long as you're baptized. Give me the sixth chapter of the book of Romans.
Romans chapter 6, we're at verse 1.
What shall we say then?
Shall we continue in sin?
That grace may abound,
God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin
live any longer therein?
Know ye not?
There's so many of us.
As we're baptized into Jesus Christ.
How were we baptized?
We're baptized into his death.
How must it be done?
Therefore we are buried with him.
Sprinkled with him.
Buried with him.
Sprinkled with him.
Buried with him.
Sprinkled with him.
Buried with him.
Water poured on you.
Buried with him.
The house of prayer for all people, take a fire hose and squirt you down.
Buried with him. Buried.
Bury your whole body.
That's right.
Got to go down in water.
That's right.
Peter says what?
Then Peter said unto them, repent.
And
be baptized, every one of you.
How?
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Why?
For the remission of sins.
The word remission means removing. That's how you get your sins washed away.
That's right.
You preachers have taught the people you born a sinner.
No, no.
Sinner is one that commit acts of sin.
That's right.
You got to earn that title.
That's right.
You are born in sin. Singular.
Mm-hmm.
And that's an inherited sin.
That's right.
The sin that was passed down to you from the first father, Adam.
That's right.
So now, mm-hmm. when you begin to learn right from wrong and choose wrong over right,
mm-hmm.
you work and earn quickly the title sinner.
Sinner.
So I said, what kind of job you got? I'm a sinner.
That's right.
How long you been working? Oh, quite a few years.
Quite a few years.
Amen. Glory to God.
That's right.
So you're not born a sinner. You're born in sin, singular.
That's right.
All right, come on.
Then Peter said unto them, repent.
Repent.
And be baptized, every one of you.
How?
In the name of Jesus Christ.
For what?
For the remission of sins.
And
you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
That's what Jesus meant when he told Nicodemus, verily, verily, I say unto you, except the man be born of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter in. When you're born of the water, you're baptized in water after you repent. In the name of Jesus Christ. And when you're born of the Spirit, you're filled with the Spirit, from the Spirit, by the Spirit, speaking in other tongues, as the Spirit of the living God give utterance.
That's
I
right.
pray that God opened up your understanding. Tune in again next week. Same holy time.
Amen.
Same holy station.
Amen.
If you want to get it right, this is your program.
That's it.
If you don't want to get it right, you don't want to watch this.
No.
Believe me, you don't want to watch this.
No.
If you want to stay ignorant, you don't gonna want to watch this.
Don't watch this.
But if you want to know,
yeah,
this is the program.
Amen.
That God designed.
Amen.
To give you knowledge. Amen. In the Word of God, I'll find a high. In the Word of God, in the Word of God.
Yes, sir!
God gave us all something good. I swear it's all that in God's word. It says, in the beginning was the Word. Word was with God, and the Word was God. We can preach it, we can sing it, and shout about it as loud as we want. There's none worthy to be praised but Him. We are fortunate to have knowledge of Him. To know Him is not luck. It is nothing short of than a blessing. It is written that I may know Him by the power of His resurrection. To know Him by such is a great opportunity. It's more than a privilege. I can never thank Him enough for interfering with our lives. Sometime the interference is not always pleasurable. But we can't deny the fact, if He interfere, it is needful. The interference of God is the mercy of God, designed to draw man back to Him. It's not about getting hype for a period of time over a message. Because when you do that, you're never real with yourself. You hear the message, apply it to yourself, but still live in reality. You integrate reality with spirituality. You keep it balanced. Always keep it balanced. When you find yourself getting hyped over something, say, you know what? I'm dropping everything. You ain't being realistic. You're just overwhelmed. That's the meaning of it. You're overwhelmed. It's like when Isaac, when Ishmael was bragging about being circumcised. That's right. Isaac was responding, hey, what is you boasting about your foreskin? And then Isaac went on talking. If the Lord would tell our father to offer me up, I'd do it. The book says, the Lord heard it. So out of all we hear, by God's mercy, take your time and apply it. But don't respond to it in a hype manner. Because your hypeness will not last. Take your time and live by it and strive to comply. Precept upon precept, line upon line. Not run at a pace to please someone else who's watching. Not run at a place because somebody else is complaining. Because one must seek God for who? Self. This is not about trying to please someone else when it comes to God. It's about pleasing God with understanding who He is, where you are and where you are not. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your patience. Before we sit down, or after I sit down, before we close, I want to have some remarks from our brother from the country of Chile in South America, Brother Alberto. And we want to hear from him because he has to go back after this service. He'll be going back to his hotel, getting prepared to go back home to South America. I do hope and pray that, and I believe God will, let us get into South America as He did the former apostles. bring South America the truth of God. Before I bring him, as I mentioned, we have Brother Jose, one of our brothers who's been doing an excellent job interpreting. Interpreting for Brother Alberto and for myself. And I appointed him to be our international interpreter for the Spanish-speaking community. And I also added on with him my other brother, Brother Ephraim. Raise your hand, Brother Ephraim. Who heard this message out of Reading, PA. And it reached him as well. He will be working along with Brother Jose and aiding us in interpreting the Spanish-speaking language to reach the people. It is written how God added daily. So I'm thankful for God giving us the necessary resources to reach the people. He gave us the resources to reach the whole French-speaking community. We got brothers in Africa who speak French fluently. When I'm in Africa on the island of Mauritius, that's what the language they all speak, French. So to go there, all the Bibles are written in French. And when I'm preaching, Minister Elvis is interpreting. Oh, he's right on my heels. Seems like if I exhale, they come out in French. So I thank God for that. So let us give our attention and our greetings to our brother and minister, Minister Alberto.
Saludo a la iglesia en el nombre del Señor Jesucristo.
Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Agradezco al Señor.
I thank the Lord
por esta maravillosa oportunidad que me ha concedido, que me ha dado.
For this marvelous opportunity that he has given me.
De acompañarles en esta santa convocación durante toda esta semana.
Of having accompanying you this whole holy congregation, this whole week. I thank him for giving me this, and I thank him for the time that I've been here.
Es muy bueno vivir una experiencia como esta.
It is very good to live such an experience like this one.
De saber que la iglesia del Señor Jesucristo está en todo el mundo.
Of knowing that the church of our Lord Jesus Christ is all over the world.
Como ya lo hemos escuchado por la palabra de Dios,
as we have heard through the word of God,
la iglesia del Señor no tiene títulos.
The church of God has no title.
Porque es la iglesia del Señor Jesucristo.
Because it is the church of the Lord Jesus Christ.
De aquel que derramó su sangre en la cruz por nosotros.
Of he who shed his blood in the cross for the love of us.
Y que vino, como Juan lo escribió en su primera carta en el capítulo 5, en el verso 20, que dice, empero sabemos que el Hijo de Dios es venido.
As St. John says,
5:20.
In chapter 5, verse 20.
Empero sabemos que el Hijo de Dios es venido.
In all we know that the Son of God has come.
Mi Señor es venido.
My Lord has come.
Y nos ha dado entendimiento para conocer al que es verdadero.
And has given us understanding to know and recognize the real one.
Nos ha dado entendimiento para conocer al Señor.
He has given us understanding to realize and recognize the Lord.
Y estamos en el verdadero.
And we are in the true one.
En su Hijo Jesucristo.
In his son, Jesus Christ.
Este es el verdadero Dios.
This is the true God.
Y la vida eterna.
And the eternal life.
Este es.
This is.
El verdadero Dios.
The true God.
Y la vida eterna.
And the everlasting life.
Su nombre es Jesús.
His name is Jesus.
El nombre que nos ha sido revelado.
The name that has been revealed to us.
La verdad es que
the truth is that
el idioma es nuestra barrera.
The language is our barrier.
Nos limita un poco
it
a entendernos.
A little bit of our understanding.
Pero hay un lenguaje que yo lo entiendo.
But there is a language that I understand.
Es el lenguaje del espíritu.
That is the language of the spirit.
Y el espíritu no tiene fronteras.
And the spirit has no barrier.
El espíritu no tiene límites.
The spirit has no limit.
El espíritu no tiene barreras.
The spirit has no barrier.
El espíritu es libre.
The spirit is free.
El apóstol Pablo nos dijo, porque el Señor es el Espíritu.
Because the apostle Paul said,
y donde,
the Lord is the Spirit.
Y donde hay,
and where there is,
del Espíritu del Señor,
of the Spirit of the Lord,
allí hay libertad.
Over there, there is freedom.
Y yo estoy seguro,
and I am sure,
que aquí
that here,
está el Espíritu del Señor.
That here, the Spirit of the Lord is here. And I am sure of that.
Y los que estamos aquí bajo esa unción,
the ones that are here under his spirit,
somos libres.
We are free.
Somos libres.
We are free.
Para alabar a Dios.
To worship God.
Somos libres para bendecir su nombre.
We are free to glorify his name.
Somos libres para llevar su palabra.
And we are free to carry his word.
Agradezco a Dios
I thank God
de conocer al pastor Gino.
Of knowing the pastor Gino.
A su madre y su esposa.
His mother, his wife.
A toda la iglesia.
All the church.
A los ministros del Señor.
All the ministers of the Lord.
Y de saber que hay un hombre con tanta valentía.
And that to know that there is a man with such courage.
Para contrarrestar, contradecir la mentira.
And to be in against the lies of the world.
Esos hombres son los que Dios necesita.
Those are the men that the Lord needs.
En muchos lugares.
In a lot of places.
Que no se acobarden ante el enemigo.
That he won't be scared when the enemy is presented to him.
Sino que lo enfrente.
If not, to not be scared of the enemy, but to fight and to present himself and carry himself the way he is to be against the enemy.
Hoy día más que nunca. Hoy día más que nunca.
Today, most than ever,
el diablo está trabajando fuertemente.
The devil is working continuously.
Para esparcir la mentira.
To spread out the lies.
Está evangelizando el mundo con el engaño.
He is evangelizing the world with the deceit.
Y la iglesia de Jesús
and the church of Christ
no puede cruzarse de brazos.
Cannot cross their arms and stay by and watch.
En mis oraciones,
in my prayers,
le he pedido al Señor,
I have asked the Lord,
en mi país,
in my country,
que en todo el continente,
that in all the continent,
en todo el mundo,
in all the world,
el Señor levante su iglesia.
That the Lord may lift up his church.
Que el Señor levante su iglesia.
That the Lord may lift up his church.
Para que alumbre.
For it can be illuminating everything.
En medio de tanta oscuridad.
In the midst of all this darkness.
Nuestra responsabilidad.
Our responsibility
es alumbrar al mundo que está en tinieblas.
Is to illuminate the world that is in the darkness.
Y para eso tenemos que vivir una vida en santidad.
And for that we must live a holy life.
No puedo alumbrar al mundo.
I cannot illuminate the world.
Si vivo como el mundo.
If I live like the world.
Solo puedo alumbrar al mundo.
I can only illuminate the world.
Si vivo como un hijo de Dios.
If I live as a son of God.
No solo ser hijo de Dios en el templo,
not only being a son of God in the temple,
sino también en la calle,
if not also in the street,
sino también en mi casa,
and not only in the street but in the house,
sino también en el trabajo,
in the job,
sino también en la escuela,
in the schools,
porque es ahí donde hay que alumbrar,
because there is where you must illuminate.
Allí están las tinieblas,
there is where the darkness is,
y la luz no se puede esconder,
and the light cannot hide itself.
Es fácil.
It's easy.
Decir soy cristiano.
To say I am a Christian.
Soy solo Jesús.
I am only of Christ.
Soy hijo de Dios.
I am a son of God.
Pero si mis hechos dicen lo contrario.
But if my acts say the different thing.
De nada me sirve.
Then it does worth nothing.
Si hay algo que el Señor criticó a los religiosos fariseos.
If there was something that the Lord criticized the Pharisees,
que su vestimenta por fuera estaba muy,
that their appearance,
muy limpias,
the garment in the outside was nice and clean,
muy santas,
very holy.
Pero ese no era el problema.
But that wasn't the problem.
El problema estaba aquí dentro.
The problem was in here.
Ahí estaba el problema.
That's where the problem
is. Y es ahí donde el Señor vino a trabajar en cada uno de nosotros.
And that's where the Lord came to work in each and one of us.
Para transformar lo que está dentro, cambiarlo, limpiarlo.
To transform what's within, to change it, to clean it, to cleanse it.
Y eso que está dentro,
and that that's within,
pueda mostrarse hacia afuera.
Can come and demonstrate itself in the out.
En todo nuestro ser.
And all our being.
Gracias. Doy a Dios. Ya esta es mi última reunión con ustedes.
I thank God.
Quiero agradecer.
And this is my last meeting with you.
Quiero agradecer la invitación del Pastor Gino de la Primera Iglesia.
I want to thank the invitation that the pastor has given me here.
A acompañarles en esta convención.
To accompany you in this congregation.
Quiero agradecer por todas sus atenciones.
I want to appreciate and thank you for all your attention.
Sus preocupaciones.
Your worries.
Por mí.
For me.
Por todo lo que ustedes han hecho por mí.
For everything that y'all have done for me.
Una vez más les reitero que estén orando por mí.
Once again, I ask you to pray for me.
Para que Dios me use aún más todavía, so, donde quiera que el Señor me lleve.
So that God can use me even more wherever He leads me.
Estoy contando las horas para regresar.
I'm counting the hours of my return.
Porque echo de menos mi esposa.
Because I miss a lot my wife.
Mis hijos.
My sons.
Mi nieto sobre todo.
His grandson overall.
Mi hermoso nieto lo echo mucho de menos.
His grandson, his favorite basically.
Y la iglesia que pastoreo, que a la cual el Señor me ha puesto al frente de ella.
And the church that the Lord has presented me and has put me up here to talk to you.
Están muy preocupados.
They are all worried.
¿Cuándo vuelve su pastor?
Of when their pastor will return.
Les mandé decir.
I've let them know.
Si me echan tanto de menos,
if they miss me so much,
que los espero a todos este martes,
that I will wait for them
en la iglesia,
this Tuesday in the church.
Gracias por todo. No tengo palabras, más palabras para agradecer a Dios, a cada uno de ustedes.
I thank you for all. I have a little bit of words. I don't have that much words to thank you, but I thank the Lord for every one of you.
Los llevaré en mi corazón.
I will take you in my heart.
No sé si nos volvamos a ver.
I don't know if we will see each other again.
Pero si no nos volvemos a ver acá en en la tierra, en el mundo,
but if we won't get the chance to see each other here on earth,
tengo la seguridad,
I have the assurance,
y espero en el Señor,
and I wait in the Lord,
que todos nos veamos,
that all of us may see each other,
en la presencia del Señor,
in the presence of the Lord.
Porque Jesús viene.
Because Jesus is coming.
Y viene pronto.
And he's coming soon.
Y viene por una iglesia preparada.
And he's coming for a church
that's prepared. No una iglesia que se está preparando.
Not a church that's being
prepared.
Sino
una iglesia preparada.
Not a church that's being prepared, but a church that is prepared.
Por eso que aprovechemos esta convención.
And that is why we must take advantage of this convention.
Estas reuniones.
And these
estas reuniones.
And these meetings.
Este hermoso espíritu.
And this marvelous spirit.
La enseñanza de la palabra de Dios.
And this teaching of the word of God.
Para no echarla al hombro.
And not toss it aside.
Sino para guardarla aquí en el corazón.
But to hold it and keep it in the heart.
Me despido con un fuerte abrazo para todos ustedes.
I dismiss myself with a big hug towards all of you.
Invitando a los que están en la televisión.
Inviting you that are
a que busquen
abroad.
La verdadera iglesia.
To seek those that are to seek the real church.
La iglesia de Jesucristo.
The church of Jesus Christ.
Dios les bendiga.
God bless you.
We thank him for those wonderful remarks. We're going to conclude this session. The Lord certainly met us in this place. We thank him for the help he continued to give us in reaching people around the world. We're going to grade a break, let you go. I believe they have dinner downstairs. So go down and fellowship with one another. Relax yourself. You ain't got to rush and run home. Sit in fellowship with one another. We'll begin the evening session, God willing, by 6:30. To you that is in the Newport News area, I'll be there 12th, 13th, and 14th, God willing, of December. The announcements were already given down there, I hope, in reference to the church business meeting. All brothers and sisters of Newport News is to be in that meeting. If you're not working, please be there. The closing year service will be held in Baltimore, Maryland, December 30th and 31st. Two-day meeting in Baltimore, Maryland at the Baltimore Auditorium, where our temporary location is. I advise you to get there early to get a seat. Tuesday service will begin at 7:00 that evening. Wednesday service will begin at 8:00. Let us be there. Let us all stand. Brother Minister Gary will close us out in prayer, God willing.
Eternal God and Father Jesus Christ, we thank you for your goodness and your mercies. We thank you, O God, for this meeting. We thank you, O God, for bringing us through the past week. We thank you, O God, for all the words that we have heard. Thank you for all the souls that have been gathered together, Lord God, to worship you. Father, we continue to thank you for our leader. Pray you continue to strengthen him, O God, and keep him. Help him, O God, that he might not faint, but that he might be encouraged through all the struggles, through all the opposition, to continue to teach your people in the way of righteousness. Help us, O God, to apply the words to our life. Father God, help us to see ourselves as blessed people, knowing that many are wanting of this knowledge and understanding that we are getting. Help us not to toss it aside, but to evaluate our lives and run towards thy commandment. Strengthen us, Lord God. Guide us. Protect us, O Father. Help us to do that which is lawful in thy sight. Bless all the ministers that minister in different areas. Help them to strive, Lord God, for holiness and to be obedient to leadership. My hallelujah to God, not to try to turn the people in their own way, but to just work according to the scriptures, that we might have a unified body, that we might be able to conquer the powers of the enemy. Give us strength. Give us knowledge and divine understanding. Those that will be traveling, oh God, over the airwaves, I pray, oh God, that you give us journeying mercies to go back to our different abodes. Strengthen us and guide us, oh God. And we give thy name the praise. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray and we say, amen.